Hey, today to everyone. So our topic for today is the formulation of test questions in the conduct of lie detection. So this is the same with the previous discussion about on how we formulate the test questions. But there are some terminologies or new terminologies that are being used in the formulation of test questions. So, but the same in the previous discussion. Okay. So there are types of questions. What are the types of questions being formulated in the conduct of lie detection? First is the irrelevant questions. Okay. So when you say irrelevant questions, these are questions designed to be emotionally neutral to examine. Okay. So yung tinatawag natin norms and neutral, these are questions that have no connection or a relation to the crime or to the what we call this to the issue being investigated. So in the relevant questions, it should be answered with the yes type of questions in which both examiner and examinee know the true answer. Okay. So lahat ng mga relevant question ipo-formulate natin, it should be answerable by yes. Okay. This relevant question is to establish the examiner's physiological norm. Okay. So irrelevant questions are mostly typically placed in the first position. Kadalasan na nilalagay yan sa ang unang katanungan din. Okay. Because the physiological responses that follow the presentation of the first questions are presumed to have no diagnostic value. So they are also placed at other points in the question sequence. So these are the examples. Okay. For example, is today is Monday or is today is Tuesday, and is your last name is Bautista. Right now you are wearing white polo shirt. These are the examples of irrelevant questions, and these questions are answerable by yes, and alam ito ng examinee at saka ng examiner. Okay, so next is the comparison question. Yung comparison question, ito yung tinatawag nating control question. Control questions. Okay, this class of questions that serve to elicit physiologic response of innocent examinee. Okay. Dito sa comparison na question test, yung ibang tawag dito is yung control question test. Okay, compares examinee's responses to relevant questions. Okay, so to their responses to other questions that are believed to elicit the physiological reactions from innocent examinees. So comparison questions ask about general undesirable acts, and sometimes the type of an event under investigation. Okay. For example, dito sa control question natin is, or dito sa comparison question natin is, doon sa burglar investigation, one comparison question might be ito yung pwede natin itanong sa mga burglary. Have you ever stolen anything? That is a comparison. Okay. So in the comparison question kasi merong types yan. We have the non-concurrent control, non-parent exclusive control questions, or yung NCECQ, hindi yung ECQ ngayon about sa COVID. Okay. Ito yung tinatawag natin non-parent exclusive control question. So pag sinabi natin NCECQ, these are questions formulated in the same category of things or matter as the relevant questions. So ang tatandaan lang natin is dito sa NCECQ is the question is separated in time form. Okay. The relevant issue with the use of a time bar. So meron siyang time bar dito sa NCECQ. Okay? So dito sa NCECQ, it is considered as an earlier in life ordinal current control questions. Ito yung kanilang mga nakaraan. Okay. Yan yung mga pwede ninyong i-formulate mga questions. Okay. During the first 19 years of your life, do you remember ever deliberately causing someone physical harm? Ito yung mga non-current control questions. Earlier in life. Okay. Some other type of control or comparison question is the current exclusive control question or yung CECQ. Ito yung tawag nating primary at saka secondary sa control question natin. Okay. Doon sa current exclusive, okay, it is formulated to be in the same category with the relevant question. But, okay, however, not separated in time. Okay. Kung yung isa kanina ay separated in time, okay, dito sa CECQ is not separated in time. Okay. For the relevant issue with the use of a time bar, okay, that's considered a current control question. It excludes specific crime from the relevant issue. Okay, example, have you ever physically hurt anyone? Okay. Ito yung tinatawag nating present time. Okay. Kung matatanda ninyo yung primary control questions, ay yung secondary control question. Okay. How about the manner or way of asking in the control question or comparison question? We have the what we call probable lie control questions and the directed lie control questions. In the probable lie, the questions designed to induce innocent people to answer in the negative, even though most are lying. While in the directed lie control questions, the examinee is instructed to respond negatively and untruthfully. Okay. Yan yung manner or way of asking dun sa control question natin. Sabi ko nga kanina yung example natin sa burglary investigation. One of the comparison question might be, for example, have you ever stolen anything? Okay. Saan po pasok yun sa directed lie control question? Okay. Another types of questions is the relevant question. Pag sinabi ko kasing relevant question, okay, by the way, dun sa comparison question, whether the comparison, dito sa comparison natin, whether the comparison is of the NCECQ or NECQ or CECQ, okay, dito sa parent exclusive control question natin, regardless whether the manner of asking is probable or direct lie, it is expected that the examinee will give no answer. Bibigyan ka ng no answer ang examinee. Okay? It's either sa NCECQ or sa CECQ control question. Bibigyan ka talaga ng no answer yan. Okay? Yes, comparison question tests are widely applicable and are used both in specific incident investigation and in screening. So, dito sa directed lie, ang isang example dyan is during the first 20 years of your life, did you answer, ever tell even one lie? That is directed control, directed lie control questions. Okay. In both forms, dito sa dalawang control question na yan. Okay. In both forms of test, the expectation is that the innocent examinees will react more strongly to the comparison question. Okay, magre-react yung innocent examinee mo doon sa mga comparison question. Okay, remember, innocent examinees will react more strongly to the comparison question. Okay. And guilty examinees, doon sa mga guilty naman, will react more strongly to relevant bastion. Remember, pag innocent, strongly react or will react more strongly to the comparison. Magre-react doon sa comparison. While the guilty, magre-react yan doon sa relevant question. Okay? So in the relevant questions, those that deals with the true issue of concern to the investigation, designed to pose a threat in the security of the deceptive or guilty examinee and elicit his or her psychological test. Okay. So one that deals with dito sa relevant questions, one that deals with the real issue of concern in relation to the issue that being investigated. Okay. Meron na siyang relasyon doon sa ininvestigahang kaso. Okay. These questions include asking whether the examinee perpetrated the target, okay, or knows who did it, and perhaps questions about particular pieces of evidence. Okay. That would incriminate the guilty person. Okay. Dito sa relevant question, meron naman tayo tinatawag na primary issue, secondary, okay, evidence connecting, okay, guilty knowledge. Pag sinabi natin primary issue, this is the strong, relevant, oriented, tawag natin crucial. Okay, this question test direct involvement. Remember, direct involvement to the matter under investigation. Ito yung mga tinatawag natin, did you do it type question. For example, on May 21, 2021, did you fire any shots that wounded the police officer of Antaman? Okay, that is the strong, relevant, or crucial, the primary issue. Okay. Direct involvement. Okay. Another one is the secondary issue, the second strongest. This is the lesser action of the crime than direct involvement. Okay. For example, regarding the robbery at the Bautista Pawnshop, did you intentionally left the back door open for the robbers to gain entry? Okay. Ito yung secondary issue natin. The second strongest. Okay. Another one is the evidence connecting. This is the third strongest na pwede natin tanungin or reformulate ng mga katanungan during the conduct of polygraph examination to determine the examiner's awareness of the nature, location of various items of evidence or proofs of the crime. Example, did you know where the stolen laptop Mr. Bautista is now? Okay. Or is the seminal stain collected at the crime scene is yours? Ito yung mga evidence connecting question natin. These are the third strongest, okay, na pwede nating tanungin. Okay. About the knowledge, guilty knowledge, okay, any knowledge committed the crime under investigation. Yung may alam ka. Okay. Do you know in particular who stole the laptop Mr. Bautista? Yung mga guilty knowledge natin. Okay. All polygraph testing techniques normally begin with the pre-test interview naman. Okay. So another one is this sky question. Okay. This question is an optional question used to verify the previous chart. Okay. Ito yung tinatawag nating suspect, yung no or knowledge, and the why is you. For example, dito sa S, do you suspect anyone? Okay, yun sa K is, do you know for sure who stole it? Okay. And the Y is, did you? Yeah. Yan yung type of question. Yan sa style question. Pero optional yan. Okay. So another one is, this sacrifice relevant. Okay. Sacrifice relevance introduce the relevant issue under investigation, which is typically answered by yes. For example, regarding whether or not you shot police officer Wantama, do you intend to answer truthfully each question about that? That is sacrifice relevant or yung SR question. This is another type of questions that being formulated. Okay, another one is yung symptomatic question or yung SY not, used to determine whether the examinee is truly convinced that the forensic psychophysiologist or yung polygraph examiner natin will not ask an unreviewed question during the polygraph verification test. And where there is something else examined is afraid to, the FP will ask him a question about, even though the FP promised to the examinee he would not. Okay. For example, are you completely convinced that I will not ask you an unreviewed question in this child? Okay. That is a symptomatic question. Is there something else you are afraid I will ask you a question about, even though I told you I would not? These are the example of symptomatic questions. Another one is the inside issue control question, or yung IIC natin. This type of question is designed to elicit a response from innocent examinee who is fearful that an error will be made on the test. For example, are you afraid that error will be made on this test regarding the shooting of police officer Watama? This is inside the issue control question. Okay. Another one is the inside issue relevant. It is designed to elicit response from the guilty examinee. Okay. Dito sa inside issue, designed to elicit the response from the innocent examinee. Okay. While the inside issue relevant, elicit the response from a guilty examinee who hopes that an error will be made on the test in the hope that this deception will not be detected. Okay. For example, are you hoping an error will be made on this test regarding the shooting of police officer Watamar? Okay. Pag sinabi mong IIC, inside issue control for innocent examinee, okay. Responses from innocent examinee, while inside issue relevant, IIR, elicit a response from a guilty examinee. Okay. So another one is the type of question, another type of question is the countermeasures. This is used to determine if the examinee tries to employ countermeasures. Okay. For example, did you deliberately do anything to try and beat the test? This is the countermeasure. Kasi may mga examinee tayo na they try to beat the machine. Di ba? Galaw yan. Pwede mong tanong yan. Did you deliberately do anything to try and beat the test? So these are the some of the formats for polygraph techniques. Okay, single issue, when there is a single issue to be verified through PDD, the zone comparison test. Yeah. Ito yung mga sequence. Sa map quadrant track zone comparison test, okay, ito yung mga question sequence niya. Okay, yung BODPI by spasticity, ito yung question sequence. Ito yung mga pwede ninyong gamitin. Okay, ito sa another is this integrated ZCT. This ito yung mga nilalagay ko na rin dito yung mga question sequence niya. Yung UCA ZCT question sequence, yeah, relevant, yeah, SR, SY, C. Ito yung mga pwede nating sundan ng mga focus para sa pagbuo ng mga question natin. Okay. Dito sa integrated ZCT, doon sa first chart is the silent answer test. Sa second chart is the down solution, stimulation. The third chart is the mixed questions. Okay, pag sinabi mong mixed questions, di ito, for example, yung R12 natin, relevant number 12 natin, pwede mo siyang i-move dun sa R6, pagpalitin mo lang yan. Then yung R6 sa position ng R9, yan, ilipat mo sa R9. Then yung R9, ilipat mo siya sa position ng R12. Yan. Pag sa third chart. Okay. And the fourth chart, yung relevant and the NECQ will be reversed. Asan yung relevant? For example, yan, yung R6 relevant mo, pwede mo siyang ilipat sa dito sa NCEQ ng current. Okay? Then yung R9 mo, pwede mo ilipat dito sa 8. Okay? Then yung R12, pwede mo siyang ilipat sa 11. Okay? Ito yung pwede nyo gamitin sequence. And another one is the multiple issue when there are two or three separate issues of general nature. Okay? Ito sa MatQuinque, Track CCT, ito yung kanyang question sequence. Pwede relevant, SR, SY, NCECQ, relevant. Ito yung mga pwede ninyong i-formulate or sequence na gamitin. Okay? lie detection test. Okay? So remember, yung sinabi ko kanina, that all polygraph testing techniques normally begin with the pre-test interview. Okay? The examinee and the examiner discuss the test. So, sa pre-test, yung test ang i-discuss yan, the test procedures, examinee's medical history, and the details of the test issues. So, the examiner also observed, during the pre-test kasi, na-observe ng forensic psychiatric physiologist yung behavior of the examinee. Okay? And the in-test formats that allows for discretion in question design, okay, may gather information to be used in choosing comparison questions for the test, okay, but depending on the complexity of the case. So the examiner-examinee interaction and the techniques, okay, the pre-test interview may last from 30 minutes to 2 hours or a long walk. Yan nagtatagal yung polygraph examination. That's a pre-test. Okay. So that's all, and thank you, and God bless.